was a girl, my own mama vowed. I must find a way to power through a noble brow. I married once for love, then my senses came. I must marry for the stature of my husband's name. On to marriage number two, I knew what I had to do. My poor husband fell ill in a year or two. Solved problem number one, now to problem number two. His doe-eyed little girl with a ginger point of view. Would I ship her off to school? No, I told her if she stayed, then she'd have to earn her keep. And so she became the maid. She was lazy, she was crazy, she was talking to the mice. She was hopelessly naive, so she had to pay the price. I moved her to the attic, out of sight and out of mind. I could have thrown her out, but I'm benevolent and kind. Children will take advantage of your good nature. So you lock them up, throw away the key. There's one on every family tree.
A grateful people.
I'll tell the things she put you through. Break their spirits so they obey. Now they'll do anything you say. Many would call it cruel, but others would call it love. Tough love. I ask you, is it a crime to strive for perfection in all things?
Oh no, they're so cute when they're little, but then they grow up and just... Life was better on my own. All the screaming, nagging chilled me to the bone. But then one day I came across a flower grown free. Its magic kept me young, so I kept it all for me. But someone dug it up, now a baby held the power. So I borrowed her and locked her up and hid her in a tower.
Years went by, all the sacrifice.
And against my better judgment, I fed her once or twice. Teenagers, now I know I wild with their young. But that's messy, manipulation's easily more fun. A little guilt, a lot of force, of course you have to lie. Remind them that without you, they shrivel up and die.
Your enemies away.
Don't be